Hello, I'm Dr. Dennis McKenna. As always, I'm joined by Dr. Fred Venditti, our Hospital System General Director, providing you the update from Albany Medical Center. Today is Thursday, July 2nd. I think about a third of our presentation today will be COVID and the rest will be non-COVID,
which is
great. But let's start with the graphs that we are all familiar with. The first one is what's happening in the capital region. Continues to be a good news story in the hospitals in the 8 counties of the capital region. Fred, we currently have 31 patients being treated for COVID.
Lowest number yet.
Yes. And you'll recall, obviously, on this campus alone at one point, we had as many as 80. So
that's
31
right.
In 8 counties is definitely moving in the right direction. The next graph shows admissions and discharges of patients with COVID-19 here at Albany Medical Center. What I'd like to point out is what's above the horizontal line are admissions, and there's been a couple days now where we've had no admissions at all.
That's great.
So that obviously also continues to be a good news story. Finally, the third graph, which is our morning census of people in the hospital with COVID-19. And as you can see by the solid purple line, we currently have 18 people in the hospital with COVID-19, 17 on the floor, 1 in an ICU bed, none on a ventilator. And Fred, that dashed purple line, those are people who are in the hospital who are actively being treated, and it's less than 10.
That's right, it is. It is. It's really tremendous. You know, Dennis, I think it's important for everybody to understand, despite how good the numbers look, we're continuing to pay attention to this. We're continuing to watch. So we're going to react if we have to.
That's a great point. Thank you for bringing that up. Speaking of COVID, we mentioned that members of our workforce recently were profiled in an art gallery exhibition in Albany. And I think while we're talking about it, we'll show some of these incredible pictures. But Fred, what are we talking about?
So Dennis, this is a gallery of pictures at the Albany Center. It's called the Healing, Portraits of the Pandemic. It's by an artist, Steve Derrick, who actually has a local connection. I think he's from Clifton Park.
Yes.
He's been doing this for a while. I think there are actually 70 portraits. A few of them are staff members, which is really terrific. He works for a company called Vicarious Visions.
Yes, we've talked about them before.
Yes, we have. Yes. And this is really a tremendous tribute to healthcare workers.
Yeah.
Thank you very much for doing this.
Yeah, indeed. They're very dramatic and I think incredibly important images of the workforce, including our own. And hopefully you get a chance to check out the exhibition.
Yes.
So thank you to him for doing that.
It.
We mentioned we had some incredible news to mention today about our health system, and so we're proud to announce today that yesterday it was officially announced that Glens Falls Hospital is now part of the AlbyMed health system, which is remarkable.
That's terrific.
Which now makes us the region's largest locally governed health system, which is something to be very proud of. And sometimes the data is important as well, the statistics. So Fred, let's share some of the data about this health system.
So Dennis, across the 4 hospitals now in the Albany Med health system, there are 1,520 licensed beds.
Wow.
And 125 outpatient sites where we see patients and provide care.
It's incredible. That care is being delivered now by 800 physicians.
Employed
physicians,
yes.
That's right. And 1.3 million outpatient visits. So we're talking about Columbia Memorial, Albany Medical Center, Saratoga, and now Glens Falls Hospital.
Very large geographic area that we cover really quite well.
We could probably spend 10 minutes talking about all the people we want to thank. There's obviously been hundreds who have worked on this, but some in particular deserve some shout out. So, Fred?
Well, I think, first of all, Jim Barba,
for sure,
who had the vision of what the Albany Med Health System should be. Jim talked about a Northway strategy, and
yes,
that's really come to fruition. Steve Frisch, who's really the architect, so the visionary and then the architect. Steve, just, you know, meticulous in his approach, very careful, thoughtful building of the network, and Glens Falls being the most recent piece. And then there are lots of other people, Jim Socia, Matt Jones,
yes,
Fran Alpert, who've worked on this to bring it to fruition. So thank you all.
Absolutely. And that's on this campus. And of course, up at Glens Falls Hospital, their CEO, Diane Chagrou, has been right from the very beginning involved in this. And so we congratulate her as well. And it's a remarkable story. And we're looking forward to what will happen.
It's really exciting, isn't it, Dennis?
For sure, for sure. Fred, what is Benny? People may not be familiar with that term, Benny, which is BH And why, Benny?
Benny stands for Better Health Care for Northeast New York.
Yes.
This is an organization we created, I think, 5 years ago now, to work with some of the population in our region to improve their health, not only through medical means, but also through socioeconomic interventions. So think population health.
Yes.
So Benny is being sort of transformed now. We're kind of morphing it, drawing it more into the general operations of Albany Medical Center. And there have been some changes. One that I wanted to call out was Dr. Manjanoff, Monge, affectionately, that we all call him, now has taken on the role not only of chief medical officer, but chief operating officer. Wow. And I'm sure Monge is going to do a tremendous job continuing to drive the initiatives forward that Benny has started.
So we've known Monge for years. He's obviously well known in the community, pediatrician, a great pediatrician.
Yes.
And we're certainly proud of him taking on that role. We should also call out Dr. Lewis Philhauer, who has been the CEO of Benny for these many years and has done a great job as well.
Tremendous job. And Lewis is still in that role as CEO.
Good. All right. Very good. Fred, you wanted to mention, I think, an important, I'll call it a public service announcement about cyber. We actually have two public service announcements
yes,
today.
Yes, we do. But
the first one is about cybersecurity. And let me tee it up. So during the COVID pandemic, I think more and more people have been working at home on computers that may or may not have the right securities in place in order to protect attacks. Now, at Albany Medical Center, we know all of our employees have had the right securities put in place because
right.
that was one of the conditions of going home. But there are people out there, bad actors, who are trying to take advantage of this.
There absolutely are, Dennis, and they keep probing us, sometimes with a little bit of success, never really compromising our systems
yes.
in a great fashion. But it's very, very important. Be vigilant. During this pandemic, there's been many, many more attempts at trying to break into not only our organization, but other organizations around the country. So be cautious.
I think a general rule of thumb is if it doesn't look right, don't click on the link. Don't never give up your credentials.
Never,
you should never have to
never
do that.
Do that.
We have an incredible cybersecurity team here. Chris Couchet leads that team.
Yes, he does.
And obviously George Hickman. So thank you to everyone for your vigilance there. Finally, you may have noticed the periodic journal that comes out, AMC Today. We haven't seen that for the last couple
That's
months.
Right.
It's paper-based, and we've been trying to reduce that. And we're going to move that from a monthly to a quarterly thing. But the page.
The page is back.
The page is back. And this came out yesterday. This is electronically sent to members of our workforce in their email. And people who are new to the organization may not be familiar, but the page is something from the past.
That's right. So I think the idea here is make it timely, make it relevant, inform the workforce about things going on within the organization, and do it in an efficient manner. You know, like the 21st century way of doing things, electronically.
Electronically. And I think it's going to come out every other week. And our communications department is world class. Thank you to Matt Markham. I'm sure Lauren McIntyre and others have been involved
yes.
in this.
Shout
so thank
out to
you.
Them. Great
them
job.
Well. Finally, Fred, we're going into the 4th of July weekend.
That's
we said
right.
we had not one but two public service announcements to make today. So we want to say something today.
We want you all to be careful. It's great to celebrate the birth of our country, and fireworks is a great way to celebrate. But they need to be used very carefully if you're going to use them. Certainly don't mix them with other activities like alcohol.
Right.
Be careful.
Yes. I mean, some form of fireworks are now legal in New York State.
They
so we
are.
Have to be very
yes.
careful about that.
That's right.
I work in the emergency department, and I can tell you, every year we get people who come in. So we've yeah. got to be careful.
Maybe this will be the first year where we won't see anyone.
And we'll take credit for it.
That's right. We hope.
All right. That'll do it. We'll be back again next Tuesday. We know many people have the 4th of July weekend off, and we hope they enjoy it. Obviously, as a healthcare organization, we'll be around 24/7 taking care of
people.
We're
here.
And we're proud of that as well. So to the members of our workforce who will be here this weekend, we thank you very much.
Thank you.
And we'll be back next week. We ask that you please take care of yourself, take care of each other, and we'll see you next Tuesday.